Hello my dear students, this is Saloni Jain. Welcome to my YouTube channel Learn Programming with Saloni. In this video, we are going to discuss about input and output function in Python. So let's start with input function. So what do you mean by input function? It is used to take input from the user. Okay, and it always returns a string type value. Okay, it will take always string type value. So what is the syntax? VAR means variable name equal input is a function name, and within quotation, within brackets, you just type a message, or you can left blank also. Okay, you can leave blank also, because if you want any message, it mean prompt to be displayed, mean if you want any message within quotation mark in this input statement, so you can take. So let's take an example. I just open my IDLE, see, and open the script mode. Okay, so just type it here. So first of all, I'm typing input, enter your name, because it takes only string type variable. Okay, but I want to store, I need a variable to store the value of enter your name. Your name is stored somewhere else. So I take a variable name. Okay, so I'm taking a variable name, and when I want to print, I use a print statement, print function, and I just type name. So what will be the output? I just run this module and save the file, like AA suppose, and just enter your name. It will show, if I enter my name Saloni, it will show you the Saloni, because I am using here name. Name is a variable. Okay, and if I put a single quote or double quote here like this, and I run the program, it will show you the name. I just enter the name, any name, I just take another name and name. So it will not print Neha, because I just put a single quote. See, so what do you mean? What I mean to say that if you want to print a variable with the print statement, you use name without quotes, because name is a variable. But if I put single quotes, okay, when I put a single quote for a variable, then it will become a message. Okay, suppose you want to print something like good morning. Okay, you just want to print good morning, and another print is name. Okay, name, simple name. Okay, so if I put here name in single quote, so what will be the output? Just run this module. Okay, just a minute. Okay, I am using here a single quote, I just take a double quotation mark. Okay, and now I run this module. See, if I enter Saloni and good morning name, because I am taking name variable in single quote. So what I mean to say that whenever you want to print a message, whenever you want to print a message, use single or double quotation mark or triple quotation mark. Okay, but if you want to print a variable, there is no need to use the single quote. It will print like this only. It will print your name. See, I just type my name, and it will print good morning Saloni in the separate lines. Okay, I hope it is clear to you all. Okay, so this is a input function. Suppose now the question is, if I want to add two values, suppose I take a equals to input, enter the first value, okay, and take the B, input, enter the second value, right? And I just print, and I am typing here A plus B. So when I put enter the value, it will add the values. No, because input, I told you, input function is used to enter only string. Okay, I just run this program. See, if I take the value, enter the first value, so my first value is suppose 5, and my second value is suppose 3, it will show 53. It will not add these 5 plus 3, it should be 8. But because I'm using input function here, only input function, because input function takes a string variable, okay, and it returns a string as well. Okay, whenever you print a variable, a plus b, it will show you the 5 plus 3. Like if I take any name, it will print my name with connect. It is a concatenation. It is a concatenation between two strings. Okay. It is simply a concatenation. But if you want to add the numbers, you have to use int function before input. Okay. And just close the another bracket here. So my syntax is complete for int. Okay, int is another function to convert your string value into integer value. Okay, now when I run this program, see, I run this program and I'm entering the value 10 and the next value is 5. So it will print you 15. Okay, and but if I print A in single quote, okay, and B is single quote, so it will print AB. Just run this, I just show you. I just enter the value, but it will print AB because I am using here single quote because it is a variable. Variable need not any codes. Okay, codes is used for the message only, like this. Enter the first value within quotation mark, enter the second value within quotation mark. So this is a message. Okay, for integer type value we use int. For floating type variable, मतलब जो decimal values होगी, अगर आपको decimal में कुछ input करना है, तो you use the float function. Instead of int function, we use the float function. And you can add the values as well. Okay? So, in this way, you can use your program. If you want to add any value, if you want to work, if you want to make a program on numbers only, then you have to use int or float. Okay? You can use any function, clear. And if I on a Python shell, if I type a equals to 10 and then print a in single quote, it will print, sorry, print a in single quote, it will print you the a. Okay, but if I print a without quote, it will print the value. Okay, and if you want both, I use within quotation mark a equals to comma a, so it will print both message as well as value. Clear? I hope it is clear to you all. Yes. Next one is print function. Print function is used to display string on the console. Console mean on the screen. Okay, so if you want to display anything on the screen, we use print function. Okay, so just I just take you on a Python IDE shell, just a minute. Yeah, if I print any message, I use the quotation mark, like good morning, right? So it will print you the good morning. Okay, it will print you the good morning because within quotation mark, whatever you want to print, it will print. Okay, similarly, I show you the here the other example, print a within quotation mark or like this, so it will print the print, whatever you print, it either a message, if a message use single quotes or double quotes or triple quotes. But if it is a value, a variable, then you have to use a without quotation mark, without variable. If I want to print value, if a variable, then it will print without quotation mark. Keep remember this, ki I cannot use a variable within a quotation mark. Okay. If I write, it will not print, it will print as it is. Whatever you print, either a variable or a message, it will print as it is. Even the message is wrong, it will print. Okay. So what is the syntax of this? It is syntax is print. Just a minute. Print, it should be in small letters. Keep remember this. Okay. See. So object means whatever you want to print. That is the object. Okay, so in this I have two main arguments. One is separators. This is a separators. See, this is a separator, or this is an end. There are two arguments. One is separator, SCP equal. By default, it takes space. If I have multiple object values, what I want to print, I want common separator between them. Okay, suppose if you want to print a name, okay, by default it will take space. Okay, just I show you in ideally, just a minute. Okay, suppose I want print three different names. I just take Neha कोमा सलोनी कोमा शमा. ओके, सो व्हेन आई एंटर दिस इट विल प्रिंट थ्री डिफरेंट नेम एंड बाय डिफॉल्ट इट टेक्स अ स्पेस बिटवीन देम. सी, बट आई हैव नॉट गिवन एनी स्पेस, बट इट विल टेक स्पेस बिकॉज सेपरेटर्स बाय डिफॉल्ट टेक्स अ स्पेस. ओके, नाउ आई अगेन आई वॉन्ट अनदर सेपरेटर. यू कैन नॉट, यू कैन यूज एनी सेपरेटर. ओके, आई जस्ट टेक अनदर सेम नेम नेहा कॉमा सलोनी कॉमा शमा. ओके, एंड नाउ आई वॉन्ट कि आई वॉन्ट हैश टैग बिटवीन देम. सो आई विल यूज सेपरेटर इक्वल्स टू हैश विद इन कोटेशन मार्क. ओके, सो आई जस्ट एंटर इट विल प्रिंट यू नेहा हैश सलोनी हैश शमा. And you can print any special character, anything you want. Suppose I want this, so it will print like this: Neha, then @signs, Saloni, @sign, and Shama. So this is called a separator. Okay, if you want a separator, another separator other than a space, by default it is a space. So we can use a separator here. Okay, within a print statement. Keep remember this: by default its value is space. And another one is end. And if I don't use any end function like this, if I use my Python script, I just have a file. Just a minute. This is suppose. And just I write here print Python. Okay. And again print programming. Right. And again I take another print statement. It is a language. So when I run this program, okay, it will show you three different lines, Python programming language, because I am using its default end separator is end argument is there. If I don't take any end argument while printing, so it will take by default, it will take new line. But if you want ki I just print /n means it will print a value without any in a same line. If I want a same line, so you can print like this here, just n equals to I just want a space. So it will print I just want space here equals to space. Okay, so it will print you a space between them, the same line. See what is the output. See, Python space programming language. Otherwise, it takes /n for new line. It will always take /n for a new line. Okay, so this is all about the end function. If you want to print the same line, I'm using here end function. So I hope it is clear to you all. Yes, it is clear to all. Yeah. So this is all about print statement. Keep remember this, there are two main argument is separator and end. By default separator value is space and end's value is /n means new line. Okay, new line or end string, you can use any string as well. You can use, I am using here space, you can take any argument as well with the same line. Agar aap, if you want to same line mein aapka kya hai output aaye, to it will you use any string. So what are the features of print? It auto converts the item into string. ये क्या करते हैं, आपकी प्रिंट स्टेटमेंट ऑटो कन्वर्ट कर देती है आइटम्स को स्ट्रिंग में और ऑटोमेटिकली आपकी उसमें स्पेस डाल देती है अगर आप सेपरेटर यूज नहीं करते हैं, बिकॉज बाय डिफॉल्ट सेपरेटर आर्ग्यूमेंट इज स्पेस. इफ यू आर नॉट यूजिंग द व्हेन यू वांट टू प्रिंट मल्टीपल ऑब्जेक्ट इन विद अ प्रिंट स्टेटमेंट एंड यू आर नॉट यूजिंग अ सेपरेटर, तो बाय डिफॉल्ट इट विल टेक स्पेस. And it appends a new line character at the end of line unless you give your own end argument. जब तक आप अपना end argument नहीं दोगे, तो it will take the new line. जैसे मैंने आपको अभी दिखाया कि new line में automatically वो चला जाता है. ठीक है, तो if you have any doubt, I just tell you about the one is the more pillars of a Python program is comment. Okay, I will show you कि if I just open my script mode and use of, what is the use of? If I don't want to use language, I just put a single quote, okay, single hash sign. So this is a single line comment. Comment means it is a dead statement just for, if you want, don't execute. It will not execute. It will will not affect any programming line. It will not give you any error. It's just a comment. If you want to type something else here, this is a dead statement like this. You, whatever you want to print, it will not. If whatever you want to write, you can write. But if hash sign is there, it has no effect on other lines. So when I run this program, it will not print anything. It will be Python programming because it is a dead statement now. Okay, if you want key, I just want key that three statement. So this is a multi line. I just put three or closing here. Okay, I'm just closing here. So now this is active and it will show you the error, or you can put here hash sign. Now it will print only the language. Okay, so this is all about hash and single triple quotes. Triple quote, it is a comment. Okay, it is also a comment. You can use two ways. One is a triple quotes, use triple quotes, or use the hash sign. If you want have a, if you want to comment in multiple lines, you use three triple quotes in the beginning and where you want to stop, where you want to make the comment. Okay, so you can use this. So this is all about today's session. So I hope, students, you liked it. And if you have any doubt, feel free to ask me, and you put in the comment section if you have any doubt regarding this topic. Okay, if you have any doubt, you can enter your doubt in the comment section. I will definitely solve your doubt. And please press the bell icon so that you get the upcoming videos update. And please subscribe my channel. Okay, it is just for you, for your students. It is for you only. Okay, so till then, keep watching, keep studying.